beg you to bear with me because my voice is not as strong as the one of the Clement. And even of Bishop Joe. But I try to do my best. Visit last year and especially the preparations for the consecration and installation of our dear Bishop Joseph. Everyone who was present for this consecration was appreciated the efforts and the dedication of so many of you in the preparations for such an event. We have to thank God above all that everything went well. In a special way, I join even the thanks of my Joseph Alessandro before me, and especially my thanks to the new Bishop Joseph Alessandro. As he said, during his last 5 years that we lived together, well, prayers, pastoral planning, meals, youthful moments, the diocese, and even difficult moments. Moments like the loss of the late Pedro Gania, the parish priest of all our parish, and also to the niece of our dear Father John Monsieur, here in Catimba, and even the loss of other brothers and sisters in the diocese and in this parish, especially because of COVID, and even because of illnesses and even road accidents. We share deep and challenges of the heritage. Looking at the present and the future, I feel very happy and positive that the diocese is now a very good hand with Bishop Joseph Alessandro, who with generosity had accepted the call to help you, guide you, teach you, be very close to you, accompanying you in building the church of Christ. He is able, but he needs your support and your prayers. So thank you. Thank you very much, Bishop Joseph Alessandro, for accepting this work. Looking back, since the first group of Franciscan Catholics in Spain were born in Garissa, one can notice that the Catholic Church has grown in the region, notwithstanding the many challenges of the environment, the climate, being a minority church among the Protestant Muslim brothers and sisters, and also the fact that many of our Christians move. They come, they stay for some time, and they proceed to other more religious. Thanks to the many Christian religious who serve the church in Garissa for these last 50 years, the faith is still alive and strengthened because of them. The gospel message, besides being proclaimed to our brothers and sisters in faith through catechism, message, and administering of the sacraments, the gospel was and is still proclaimed through acts of human assistance, what we call charity and development, especially in the fields of education, health, and life. Today, I would like to appreciate the presence of representatives of the parish, accompanied please by their respective sisters or in the nation. Thank you all for the welcome, for the welcome gave me every time I visited your respective parish. I am confident that you will continue the same spirit to welcome the new bishop every time you will come. Today, we welcome among us the Catholic brother from Nairobi, who came here to represent their community. welcome also our special guest, so called
about
God and your calling to be faithful, to use your gifts, and to serve others in so many ways. Faith really matters. Faith is life. It's progress. It's a journey. So that's why Pope Francis called to journey together in the spirit of the Synod of Synodality. Finally, I recognize Bishop apologize to you, especially for the times that some of you might say that they were not listening to you. So, I ask you for my prayer is that under the protection of Our Lady of Consolation, together with your children and priests, to continue to flourish, to grow in all that you do, for the glory of God's name and the glory of our brothers.